Press the bell icon and never miss any updates from India Forums.
किसी बात पे फरमाया है गणित के पन्नों को लफ्जों की मेहरबानी में पर लगता है डर खाब तो नहीं
Melodious voice, isn't it? And I'm sure you must be very curious to know who is behind this voice. It's none other than Zain Khan Durrani, who is all set for the release of his debut film, Kuch Bhi Ke Alfaaz. And accompanying him is his leading lady, Gitanjali Thapa, and director Honor.
Hello.
To Zain, sabse pehle hum aapse jana chahenge, aapki debut film hai. How excited and how nervous are you for this one?
As excited as it gets, as nervous as anyone would be, but I'm also very happy that I'm coming out with such a beautiful movie. And it's coming on Valentine's Day. It's about romance and it's about love, and I think people would love the movie and come out with a very romantic mood and go with their dates and fall in love with the movie. So I'm really happy. A little bit nervous, yes. It's my first movie. So the nervousness is always there. But I think that's overpowered by the amount of love that we have already received for the movie and that we expect and hope and pray to receive.
So you know, we got to know that throughout the film, you both ek hi bar, I think, mile the throughout the film. And the rest of the film was shot like singularly. So how was that one meeting? How did it strike your chemistry?
It was how you would expect it to be, like if you've been speaking to someone over the phone for a long time and you haven't met that person and that person sounds wonderful like Zain does, and you've been chatting, opening yourself up, you know, really talking about your deep secrets, just sharing your thoughts, your views about things, and then there is that build up to finally meet that person, and which happened because we were not meeting, because Onir did not want us to meet because he wanted to be as organic and real as possible. So when we finally met, it was beautiful. It was I was really looking forward to it because everyone around me would talk about Zain, and while even the makeup artist was doing my things, Zain, I saw Zain today, she's so handsome and all of that. There was so much build up. So the final day I was like, I'm meeting Zain today, I'm going to finally meet him, and yeah, it was worth all the build up, and it really helped. You can see it on screen, what we think or feel for each other, like it shows because of all the build up.
I think the build up was intensified by the fact that everybody on the set was totally in love with her, and I would get to hear so many stories and so many compliments showered on her, and everybody would come to me and they'd be like, Gitanjali did this, Archie did that, and this and that, and it was just, you know, making me more impatient. But I think it paid off because when we were supposed to meet, on set, I did not have to prepare for the scene. It was happening organically. I was already nervous when I had to go there and do the scene with her, and when I finally saw her, I think the moment in the movie when you watch it, you'll realize how beautiful a point in the movie it is, and it actually felt like that.
Sir, abhi hum aapse janna chahenge, itna pyara naam, Kuch Bhi Ke Alfaaz. What's the inspiration behind this?
I think the name was there jab script mere paas aaya, aur first I fell in love with the name. Actually, you know, Kuch Bhi Ke Alfaaz just sounds nice. Then I found out the meaning because I wasn't that strong. And then when I read the script, I fell in love with the script and realized how it was all came together, a beautiful film about the experience, the beauty of love, falling in love again in the world of WhatsApp and Tinder and, you know, everything on, like, social media, but the beauty of social media.
So we read, you know, the first scene that has happened, so usme se ye pata chala ki it still has that essence of old school romance. So how did you make it? How do you make it possible?
My age, you know, so the old school romance came from me, my experience, and the new age romance came from my young writer, Abhishek Chatterjee. I think he brought that in, and with that I infused my memories of what, you know, love felt like, and I think the essence of love is timeless, you know, so that it's actually not old-fashioned, it will be in fashion always.
So can we say ki ye story aapki real life story se inspired hai?
Har kisi ki real life story se kahin na kahin to inspired hai, kyunki hum everyone has those moments of insecurities where you think that I'm not beautiful enough, I'm not good enough, nobody loves me. But you know, the minute you realize your inner beauty, you will find that someone who loves you, who will be there for you. That someone's, you know, not necessarily one, maybe, you know. And I think this film celebrates that. And it's a part of my life, it's a part of her life, part of his life, part of your life, maybe.
So, you know, like to both of you now, ki jaisa main dekha hai trailer mein, ki it's all about social media, you know, sending texts and everything. So, real life mein aisa kitni baar hua hai aap logon ke saath?
Harga.
सबके साथ हुआ है. थिंक हम ऐसी दुनिया में रहते हैं जहाँ हमारा दाहिना हाथ सोशल मीडिया. तो मेरे ख्याल में
नहीं. Where's the left hand?
That's like an arching. That's an arching question.
I'm in my character right now.
बहुत मर्तबा हुआ है एक्चुअली. मैं कई दफ़ा ऐसा कई मेरे कई जिंदगी में जो दोस्त हैं अभी भी उनमें से कई मुझे सोशल मीडिया पे मिले. तो मेरा ख्याल में ये स्टोरी ऐसी है जिसको जिससे हर एक इंसान रिलेट कर पाएगा. 95% ऑफ द टाइम जितने रिलेशनशिप्स हैं आजकल मेरे ख्याल में कुछ ना कुछ वो सोशल मीडिया से रिलेटेड हैं. यहाँ पर एक इंसान मौजूद हैं अभी नॉट हेयर बट अराउंड अस जिनकी शादी सोशल मीडिया से हुई है. ही वॉज डेटिंग समबडी फॉर 6 months ऑन सोशल मीडिया एंड देन गॉट देयर एंड नाउ दे मैरिड फॉर 10 years. सो जब मैंने वो स्टोरी सुनी तो इट जस्ट फेल्ट लाइक वी ना वी कैन ऑल रिलेट टू इट. We all have had those experiences right from the time there was Orkut and right Yahoo Messenger and everything. And I think those were the time we were really getting to explore this space. And now it's so big, it's everywhere. It's on Facebook, you have WhatsApp, you have Tinder and all of that. And so many people meet so many people through all of these means. I think then there are matrimonials as well, where you meet people on social network and you get married to them with the intention. So social media is such an integral part of our life na, ke nobody, I don't think anybody can turn up and say, I'm like, I haven't done anything, I haven't met anybody through it. You all have.
Okay, what about you?
I think it's not just about meeting someone through social media. I think it also helps you stay in touch with people you meet and makes you helps you stay be more frequent, you know. Now I probably text my family more often because of that, and somehow, and also just keeps you informed about what's happening. And I think there's a very thin line between showing off and sharing. So as long as you share and you want to share, it's beautiful. Like you see something beautiful and you want to share it with your loved ones, I think it builds love, it builds that relationship, just because it helps you share so many things. Could be anything. So we don't only find people, we can also share and stay in touch with people better. And we have so many platforms we can use now to stay in touch. There are apps just for couples where you can have a common calendar and do so many things together. So I think it also helps you build a relationship, not just find someone. I think it's great though, this whole social media thing.
So have you found someone on social media still late?
I'm still looking. I don't know, I'm not going to answer that question.
Sir, aap
swiping.
Okay. Sir, are you that active on social media ki aapko bhi aaye hai aise?
Absolutely. In the 90s when initially the internet and all started, I used to be up for hours every night in chat rooms, chatting with all kinds of strangers, going out for dates at 1 in the night. I've done all that. And also social media has given me one of my films was crowdfunded and crowdsourced through Facebook, Twitter. So, you know, for me, social media has given me so much. It has given me some of my closest friends. It's given me a film. It helps me connect to all people who discover about me and keep connected with my films because they give me that love. So I think it's precious.
Okay. So, you know, as I mentioned earlier, ki humne dekha ki trailer mein bhi aap ek dusre se nahi milte. So what was the most difficult part to shoot? Difficult scene basically, most difficult scene.
तो ऐसा कुछ नहीं था.
मैं तो born actor था.
There's a scene in the movie where I'm slapped. तो वो थप्पड़ मुझे 5 दफा पड़े वो रीटेक्स की वजह से. तो वो सबसे मुश्किल रहा मेरे ख्याल में. ऐसा कोई ऐसी डिफिकल्टी नहीं थी. हर सीन हर डे वाज अ मेमोरेबल डे. Pehli movie, then a movie about romance, a movie shot in Calcutta, such a beautiful script, a national award winning artist to work with.
मेरा तो कुछ किस्मत ही है इसने हाँ बोला.
अच्छा. ऐसा जो कोई मुश्किल तब इंसान कहता है जब इंसान को कोई चीज अच्छी नहीं लगती. जब आपको वो चीज़ अच्छी लगती है, जब आप उससे मोहब्बत करते हैं, आप चाहते हैं वो करना, देन वो मुश्किल भी एक एक बड़ी प्योर और बड़ी प्यारी चीज़ बन जाती है. तो ऐसा कोई मुश्किल चीज़ नहीं लगी, बस वो थप्पड़ मेरे ख्याल में बाहर से भगाने पड़े.
I wasn't slapped, thankfully. I can't remember any single instance that was very difficult or anything. I think before we started shooting, that night before the first day is always really bad because I was just tossing and turning. Kal first day hai, kya hoga, kaise hoga, you know. So I think more than the shooting, that thing that you just make up in your own head, you know, that oh my god, this is probably, or thinking of the negative things. I think that night before the shoot was the most difficult thing if we started shooting.
Sir, of course.
For me, one of the things, like with her, one had to be always, you know, very consciously looking through the camera. Mm-hmm. So that the makeup continuity, because you are creating those spots, is exactly, you know, there. There were a lot of production, because we shot the film in 19 days. For me, my actors were a pleasure because I didn't have to go through any stress with any of my actors, but just handling everything else, you know, to shoot an entire film in 19 days is not easy. You have to be on your toes. With Zain, I think the most difficult part was telling him to forget about his looks. You know, this character does not care about it, and just, you know, let it be. Forget, don't look at the camera. Don't look at the mirror. You know, just forget it, let me decide, you know. And keeping him away from trying to look, find out who this pretty Archie is. Those two are like really difficult things. But no, otherwise that's, I think it was, like when I look back, I can only think of the good times we all had.
Yeah.
And you can see that with us. And all the good food that we had in Kolkata, you know. So I feel it's a film which only brings good memories to me.
Okay. So, sir, as you just said, that, you know, it was difficult for you to keep him away from the mirror and from looking himself. So, sir, sabse pehle, I would like to know, what was the main motive behind keeping them away? I think they didn't even meet.
I think, you know, like, I mean, you must have experienced it. I'm sure you've chatted up people whom you have never met. You know, when you talk to people, then you start imagining, your eyes imagine. And I wanted my actors, when they're talking, you know, you're imagining that what must that voice be doing, thinking. If you already have that slight bit of, I think that magic is somewhere gone. And I really think that when they meet each other, after having spoken to each other every day for so many hours, because every day she had to give him the cue, either they were, you know. And I feel that, you know, if they already knew each other, I would have probably told them, when you meet, just go hug. And I remember still telling Gitanjali that you see him for the first time, what would you do, you know. And I don't want to tell you what she does, but I think both of them were in a way almost anxious, and there was this nervous element where you are literally trembling within. And I think that beauty was there, because, you know, however, you know, you were not acting, you were experiencing that.
Yeah. So what was your first reaction, both of you, when you first met each other on the sets?
I felt like Alfaz. Would have felt, yes, entirely. I saw her and I was taken aback. Itni sari cheeze log bol rahe the set pe inke bare mein, ki itni khoobsurat hain aur ye hain woh. Mere khayal mein jab main unko dekha, to main socha ki yaar ye jitna bhi bol rahe the kam bol rahe the. A shayar had to speak. So it was, that moment was full of so many things. Ek to main unko khud as Zain dekh raha tha, ek Alfaz dekh raha tha, then mera first shot tha woh movie mein.
God, you were watching her as Zain? If I knew that, I was a cut. He made me believe that he was Alfaz. I was more Zain.
He's such a brilliant actor.
Oh my god.
It was wonderful. I mean, just to put a face to someone you've been talking to all this while, you know, like you're thinking maybe he looks like that, maybe he is this, he is that, and finally it materializes in front of you. So you just don't know what you're looking at, but you also know what you're looking at, you know, and there's also this slight awkwardness, which is beautiful, you know, which if we already knew each other, I don't think we could have, it's possible to enact that. But it was really natural, that nervousness, that awkwardness. We were a little awkward with each other. So, yeah, I think it was awkward and it was very fulfilling. And also, yeah, there was still something missing, you know, which is because of that awkwardness. You don't know what to do, what not to do. Yeah, I mean, you have to watch the film and you can just see it on screen.
So, you know, Valentine's Day is just around the corner and the film is all about romance. Mm-hmm. So, can we have Zain proposing Gitanjali?
Oh, okay.
You should say Alfaz proposing to
Archie.
Okay, Alfaz yeah. proposing Archie, and then Archie also has to propose to Alfaz.
Archie
the
will think about
that. Why not the ladies first, no?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
There's a nice film I heard, Kuch Bhi Ke Alfaz, coming on 16th of February. Do you want to go? Actually, if you don't want to go, it's okay. Do you want to go or not? Chalo fir.
That was amazing. Shairana sootna padega.
Alfaz, after all.
Khayal ho agar tum, to bahut haseen khayal ho. Tumko soch ke hi zindagi guzar jayegi. Lekin ab jab tum paas ho, to chalo tumhe mil ke bata dun. कि तुम अपने ख्याल से भी ज्यादा खूबसूरत हो।
Falling, I guess. Wobbly knees. That's just Archie reaction.
So one last message for your fans.
Hi, I'm Gitanjali. I play Archie in Kuch Bhi Ke Alfaz. It's releasing on 16th of February. Please watch our film and happy Valentine's Day.
A movie is a WhatsApp kind of romance. Come fall in love with love again. Watch Kuch Bhi Ke Alfaz on 16th of Feb and happy Valentine's Day.
16th of Feb, Kuch Bhi Ke Alfaz releases. Celebrate your love with these two beautiful people, Alfaz and Archie.
This is Priyanka Chauhan signing off for now with cameraman Babaji, India Forums, Mumbai.
Adab, this is Zain Khan Durrani and you're watching India Forums.